Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market for Thursday morning. We're coming up to 9 a.m. on the East Coast, and stock index futures are down across the board. Dow futures currently down about 65 points, so we're looking for a lower open at 9:30 Thursday morning. Let's start off this morning looking at those warning signs that we've been tracking. And of course, we start off with the VIX, and the VIX traded through the upper channel line yesterday. So we have a big divergence between options traders and stock traders right now. Options traders a lot more cautious about the future of the stock market. We need to close above 1441 for the VIX for the S&P 500. We need to close above 1582 for the VIX for the NASDAQ. And that is a little closer to generating a buy signal on Thursday. So we're looking at that divergence, and it's not looking very bullish. What would be bullish is if the VIX was trending lower, and it has not been trending for a couple of weeks now, and that is not healthy for the market. If the stock market's trending higher, the VIX should be trending lower. That's not the case. That's a warning sign. Now, we've talked about the Russell and the ZACs this week, and so the broader market is starting to move lower. The 30 stocks in the Dow, the 100 stocks in the NASDAQ 100, 500 stocks in the S&P 500, still holding up very well at all-time highs, just coming off those all-time highs. The rest of the market is heading lower. That's a concern. You know, of course, if the indexes are falling, we want to buy the bear ETFs. So we're back on a buy signal for the bear for the Russell 2000. Next up, we're looking at U.S. bank stocks. The divergence here, we've got those major indexes hitting all-time highs. Bank stocks coming down. We've got the Bank of America on a sell signal. And so that is not good for the market going forward. And last up, that U.S. dollar index has been trading in a tight range for the last couple of weeks now. It has certainly been a major performer on the upside recently. And I think at some point in the not so distant future, in the next couple of days or so, we're going to probably see a change in direction for the U.S. dollar. And of course, if the U.S. dollar moves lower, then the rest of the currencies move higher. And that might give some relief to the weak commodity sector. Speaking of commodities, let's take a look. There's our commodity tracking ETF slipping even lower yesterday. And that probably had a lot to do with the price of crude oil. A little pop in the price of gasoline yesterday, and then natural gas heading up, making a higher high for this move yesterday. Still hasn't been able to close above 23.44. If we can do that, then we should be on our way to $25. There's copper trading in the channel once again. There's gold coming back to the upper channel line yesterday. A close below 112.08 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. Platinum still has not participated, and that, of course, makes me a little queasy about the whole undertaking. But here we are. We're still on a buy signal for silver. That would change on Thursday with a close below $15.12. Next up, we're looking at currencies, and we talked about the U.S. dollar. There's the U.S. dollar trading in a tight range for the last couple of weeks. So it has stopped trending, and the euro has stopped trending to the downside. And it traded through the upper channel line yesterday. We're looking for a close above 25, 125.50. That's where we closed yesterday. So right on the upper channel line for the euro. There's the British pound, a little buying there. Japanese yen continued to move lower, so no relief there for the falling Japanese yen. And there's the Canadian dollar trading in the channel on Wednesday. Next up, we're looking at the bond market, and here's another market that stopped trending. We've got the bonds in the channel. We've got the total bond market ETF heading down, closing below the lower channel line yesterday, generating a new sell signal. And there's the iShares pulling back a bit yesterday, still on a buy signal, still above the upper channel line. So the 30-year bonds certainly not trending right now. Next up, let's look at the stock market. We had an inside day for the global Dow, still nothing going on in emerging markets. There's the Dow itself, just coming off an all-time high on Tuesday. The TSX, we were looking for it to move up, hit 15,000, did 15,000 and change yesterday before pulling back and closing just below 15,000. So that target has been hit. Next up, the S&P 500, almost an inside day yesterday. And so we're still trading above the upper channel line, so not that concerned about a sell signal on Thursday. There's the NASDAQ, again, a little pullback from the all-time high on the previous day. Now, there's the Russell, there's the ZAX Microcap. Both have been on sell signals for a couple of days. Both had hard days yesterday, so microcaps, mid-caps, small caps, all heading lower on Wednesday. The Venture Exchange had a pullback, still on a buy signal, so we still have some strength, even though we had a pullback in the precious metals yesterday, still some strength there. Looking at U.S. bank stocks, we talked about that earlier. Canadian bank stocks making a new higher high for this move on Tuesday. Credit card stocks in the channel. There's energy stocks in the U.S., energy stocks in Canada, nothing going on there. Gold stocks, a big pullback, a reversal from the nice move we've had over the past couple of days, still holding above the upper channel line. Similar situation in Canada. Of course, in the channel is neutral, above the upper channel line is still bullish. Inside day for semiconductors on Wednesday, and there's the transports, another little concern pulling back into the channel on Wednesday. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. There's the VIX starting to poke its head out above the hourly flypaper channel. We're on an intraday buy signal. This is a bullish pattern. We've continued to make a series of higher highs, higher lows, higher high, higher low. And that, of course, is a bullish pattern. And so here we are coming into Thursday on an intraday buy signal. That would change with an hourly close below 1395. For the S&P 500 cash index, we need an hourly close above 2049.86 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Thursday. 4231.92 for the NASDAQ 100. And 73.89 for the XAU. XAU came down through the 200 hour, but hasn't broken the 50 and 100 hour and has not gone through the flypaper channel yet, so all is not lost. And last up, the TSX. If we can punch through 15,000, look for move up to 1578, 15,156. But I think with what's going on in the US this morning, we might see some downward pressure in Canada. The first sign of weakness on Thursday is going to be an hourly close below 14,951. As we've seen by looking at the charts, the broader market in the U.S. is starting to break down. Hopefully we got you mentally prepared for this to happen. We've been talking about buying the VIX or buying volatility over the last couple of weeks, getting prepared for a pullback in the market, and it looks like it might be starting. What we're seeing in the pre-market this morning isn't enough to break the major indexes on Thursday, but it might be the start of something. And of course, we're going to look for a pullback in the US dollar to help spark an up move in the commodity sector. Okay, that is all for this morning's presentation. I'll be back in a while to take a look at the 10 most actively traded Canadian stocks from Wednesday's trading action. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.